Hello everyone, now we shall deal with the deflection of the PSC beams. Second model, second part. The vertical distance between straight longitudinal axis and the bent up longitudinal axis is called deflection, and it is denoted by the symbol delta and measured in millimeter, that is mm. Say this is the horizontal longitudinal axis of the beam, and due to the application of the loads, this is the bent up longitudinal axis of the beam. The vertical distance between these two longitudinal axes is nothing but the deflection of the beam. The deflection produced due to pre-stressing and eccentricity, dead load and live load is called as short term or instantaneous deflection. The deflection produced due to creep and shrinkage is called long term deflection. In terms of deflection, we have two categories, short-term deflection and long-term deflection. Short-term deflection is produced due to the pre-stressing force and eccentricity, dead load and live load. And the long-term deflection is due to creep and shrinkage of the concrete. Now, the deflection produced due to dead load and live load will be in downward direction, and the deflection produced due to pre-stress and eccentricity will be in the upward direction. Say, concentrating this diagram, due to the applications of dead load and live load, the beam will going to deflect in the downward direction. The beam will going to deflect in the downward direction. That is the meaning of this statement. In the same way, the deflection produced due to pre-stress and eccentricity will be in the upward direction. Say, that is about the explanation for this diagram. Due to pre-stressing and eccentricity, the deflection will be in the upward direction. Due to dead load and live load, the deflection will be in the downward direction. We shall concentrate about the sign convention. Upward deflection is taken as negative and downward deflection is taken as positive. Means the deflection that is produced due to dead load and live load will be taken as positive, that is downward deflection. In the same way, the deflection produced due to pre-stressing force and eccentricity, this deflection is taken it as negative. That is about the sign convention. Now there are many factors that will going to affect the deflection. If you go through the each formula, you will come to know about this. There are many factors which will going to govern the deflection. The main factors which will going to affect the deflection are magnitude of the imposed load and self weight, magnitude of pre-stressing force, span of the member, cross-sectional area of the member, modulus of elasticity of the material, moment of inertia of the cross-sectional area, eccentricity of the cable, shape of the cable, fixity conditions, creep, shrinkage of the concrete, relaxation of steel stresses, grade of concrete and grade of steel. And finally, humidity, temperature and water cement ratio. These parameters will be included in the formula, because once you come across with the formula to calculate the deflection, it will be appearing, means these parameters will be appearing there. Now first we shall go with the instantaneous deflection. Instantaneous deflection can be calculated by moment area method. It is also called a short-term deflection of the pre-stressed member, and it is governed by the bending moment and flexural rigidity of the member. First we shall take up about this instantaneous deflection. Mohr's moment area table is readily available for the estimation of deflection due to pre-stressing force or self-weight or imposed loads. Okay, this is about the Mohr's theorem. Means by using Mohr's theorem, you can calculate the slope. If you differentiate the slope, you are going to get the deflection. If you divide that slope with the flexural rigidity, then you are going to get the deflection of the beam. Say it is a simply supported beam loaded with irregular loading. Say this is the nature of the bending moment diagram. Now we need to take the moment of this area about the support in order to calculate the deflection at the center of the beam, that is deflection at C. Now first slope at A means at the support. Slope at A is equal to area of the bending moment diagram between A and C. A and C, it includes half of the bending moment area we need to consider. That is about the Mohr's theorem, concept behind the Mohr's theorem. Divided by EI. EI is the flexural rigidity. Now, slope, that is theta A, is equal to bending moment area between A and C. A and C means from support to the midspan, divided by EI. Now, in order to calculate deflection at C, moment of this area means theta A means only area, bending moment of the area. Now, we need to take the moment of the area of the bending moment diagram between A and C divided by EA. This is the slope. Theta is the slope. Theta is equal to A by EI. In the same way, delta is equal to A by EI into X bar. X bar, this indicates the moment of this area about the support. About the support only, you need to consider the moment. It is all about the Mohr's theorem. Now we shall take up the short term deflections. That is deflection due to, first we shall concentrate on deflection due to live loads. Then we can go with the deflection due to dead loads. Say it is a simply supported beam loaded with UDL. In the diagram it is given. The intensity is W kilonewton per meter. Span of the beam is L. Say it is a simply supported beam UDL. From the Mohr's theorem we have delta is equal to A into X bar divided by EI. So this is the formula to calculate the deflection of the beam at the midspan. Now first we have to write down the bending moment diagram for this loading condition. So it is a simply supported beam loaded with UDL. Then the bending moment diagram will be parabolic in variation. Maximum height of this bending moment diagram will be WL square by 8. Now delta is equal to A into X bar divided by EI. A means area of this parabolic curve, that is the shaded region, means from support up to the midspan, that is 2/3 of the base into height, 2/3 into base from support to the midspan. It will be L by 2 because the total span is L. 2/3 times base into height, base is L by 2. And the height of this bending moment diagram is WL square by 8. That is WL square by 8 into X bar. X bar means that is the centroidal distance of the shaded area from the support. From the support you need to take the X bar. Means say the centroid of this area will be somewhere at this point. From this point to the support, that is X bar. That is 5/8 times the base, 5/8 into L by 2. Since it is a sector, that is 5/8 into L by 2. On simplification, we get delta as 5/384 into WL square, WL to the power of 4 divided by EI. Since the deflection that is produced due to application of the live load, the resultant deflection will be in the downward direction. Hence, we need to take this deflection as positive because we are going to assume that the deflection produced due to live load and dead load will be positive, sagging bending moment. In the same way, the deflection produced due to pre-stressing force and eccentricity will be in the upward directions. For that one, we have to take it as negative. In this case, the deflection is positive. Downward deflection, we are going to consider it as positive. Now, second one, say it is a simply supported beam with a point load. It is a simply supported beam. Span is L, point load intensity W. Apply the Mohr's theorem. Delta is equal to A into X bar divided by EI. For calculating the area, first we need to write the bending moment diagram. For the point load, there will be the linear variation. Say this is the bending moment diagram. The height will be WL by 4. Now, area will be area of the triangle, means half of the bending moment diagram, only shaded area. Half into base into height. Half into base is L by 2, height is WL by 4 into centroidal distance.
centroid of this point to the distance between centroid of this shaded area to the support, that is 2 by 3 times the base, 2 by 3 into L by 2 divided by EI. On simplification, we get delta is equal to 1 by 48 into WL cube divided by EI. Since it is a live load, the deflection will be in the downward directions, and this one also we have to consider it as positive. Now, simply supported beam with the 2-point loads. It is a simply supported beam of span L, and it is loaded with 2-point loads. The intensity of the load will be W. On simplification by applying the Moore's theorem, we get this formula, that is delta is equal to 23 divided by 648 WL cube by EI. In the same way, cantilever beam loaded with UDL, cantilever beam loaded with VDL. If I apply the Moore's theorem, we'll get this formula, delta is equal to 1 by 8 WL power 4 divided by EI. In the same way, cantilever beam loaded with point load. So this is the cantilever beam loaded with point load. Applying the Moore's theorem, again we can derive this formula, delta is equal to 1 by 3 WL cube by EI. All these, the deflection produced due to live load will be in the downward direction, and we need to assume it as positive. And the same way, deflection due to dead load. We know that dead load means it is the self weight of the member. It will be applied in the form of the UDL throughout the span. Same, we have the already derived the formula, that is delta is equal to 5 divided by 384 into WL to the power of 4 divided by EI. It is also in the downward direction, hence it is to be treated it as positive. Suppose if you consider the cantilever beam, this formula you need to use to calculate the deflection due to self-weight of the member. Now, before going to the effect of tendon profile, first we shall also go derive these formulas. I have derived those formulas. Say first I have derived the deflection due to dead load in simply supported beam. Say this is a simply supported beam. This is the sagging bending moment. Sagging bending moment, we need to take it as positive. Delta and x bar. X bar means centroidal distance between centroid of the figure to the support. Say this is the x bar. From Moore's theorem, we will be having delta is equal to A into x bar divided by EI, which is equal to area of this sector, 2 by 3 times base into height. 2 by 3 into base is L by 2, because only shaded part we need to consider according to Moore's theorem. 2 by 3 into base into height into x bar. X bar means distance between centroid of the figure, means half of the centroid of the bending moment diagram, to the nearest support. From this point to the support, that is x bar. For a sector, it will be 5 by 8 times the L by 2. L by 2 means this is base of the half of the bending moment diagram. 5 by 8 times the base, 5 by 8 into L by 2. On simplification, we got this formula, 5 by 384 WL raised to 4 divided by EI. Due to dead load, the deflection will be in the downward direction, hence we need to treat it as positive. In the same way, deflection due to dead load in case of cantilever beam. By applying the same principles, by using the Moore's theorem, we can derive this formula, delta is equal to 1 by 8 WL raised to 4 divided by EI. Dead load means it will be causing the downward deflections, hence we need to take that deflection as positive. Now, deflection due to live loads. Simply supported beam loaded with UDL, same as that of the dead load. We need to use this formula, delta is equal to 5 by 384 WL raised to 4 divided by EI. Second one, simply supported beam loaded with point load. Simply supported beam loaded with point load at the mid span. From Moore's theorem, we have delta is equal to A into X bar divided by EI. Say this is the resultant bending moment diagram. The resultant bending moment diagram due to live load is positive. This is very important. Positive bending moment. That is sagging bending moment we can expect due to loading conditions. Now area of this shaded triangle, half into base into height into x bar, distance of this centroid of this shaded area to the nearest support. Say this is the x bar is equal to 2 by 3 times the base, 2 by 3 into L by 2, 2 by 3 into L by 2, say this is L by 2, and simplification we get it as delta is equal to 1 by 48 WL square by EI, and also this deflection is in downward direction, also we need to take this one as positive one. Now simply supported beam loaded with 2-point loads at 1/3 of the span. Say this is the resultant bending moment diagram. Now we have the height of the bending moment diagram as WL by 3. On simplification we get delta is equal to 23 divided by 648 WL cube by EI. We can directly simplify by converting or by dividing this figure into a rectangle and a triangle. On simplification we get this value, that is delta is equal to 23 divided by 648 into WL cube by EI. The thing is, you need to remember these formulas, because once you know the formula you can directly substitute in the formula to calculate the net deflection of the beam. The same way cantilever beam with the UDL, if the beam is loaded, cantilever beam is loaded with the UDL, then we can have this formula, delta is equal to 1 by 8 WL power 4 divided by EI. Same way cantilever beam loaded with point load, delta is equal to 1 by 3 WL cube by EI. Now we shall move to the deflection produced due to pre-stressing force and eccentricity, that is effect of cable profile on the deflection of the beams. Now till now we have seen the deflection produced due to dead load and live load. Both these loads will be causing the downward deflection of the beam, and the deflection will be treated as positive. Now the deflection due to tensile force will be producing the hogging bending moment in case of the beams. Hence we need to take the deflection produced due to pre-stressing force as negative, because it will be causing the hogging bending moment, that is negative bending moment. So we shall consider the effect of different cable profiles. In the first one we have simply supported beam carrying a cable which has constant eccentricity throughout the span. Say it is a simply supported beam, it has two supports. The cable is having constant eccentricity throughout the span. Say eccentricity of the cable is small e. Now the deflection, that is the bending moment, is nothing but the moment here, moment due to pre-stressing force and eccentricity. Now we can write the moment as force into distance. Now the height will be P into E, force into distance will be the moment. Say this will be the nature of the resultant bending moment diagram. It will be negative because pre-stressing force will going to cause the hogging bending moment. The cable profile, irrespective of the cable profile, it will going to cause the hogging bending moment in case of the beams. Hence we need to take it as negative. Now say this is the resultant bending moment diagram, it is negative. Now delta is equal to, from Moore's theorem we have this formula, A into x bar divided by EI, which is equal to A, area of the shaded region, it is a rectangular portion, base into height, base is L by 2, height is P into E, that is P into E into L by 2, this is area, into x bar. X bar means distance between centroid of the geometrical figure to the nearest support, from here to the support, that is L by 2 into 1 by 2, that will be L by 4, all divided by EI. Now on simplification we get this formula, delta is equal to 1 by 8 PEL square divided by EI. delta is equal to 1 by 8 times PEL square divided by EI. As I told, the pre-stressing force will go into cause the upward deflection, hence the resultant deflection will be in the upward direction, hence the sign convention we need to follow is negative. Negative sign convention is to be followed for the upward deflection of the beam. This is about the first condition. Now, simply supported beam carrying a cable which is linearly bent, having a maximum eccentricity E at midspan and zero at supports. Say it is a simply supported beam having a linearly bent cable having maximum eccentricity E at the support and zero at the supports. Eccentricity E at the midspan and zero at the supports. Now the resultant bending moment diagram will be like this. It is a triangular variation. On simplification, by applying the Mohr's theorem, we get delta is equal to A into x power divided by EI, which is equal to area means half of the bending moment diagram. Now the moment will be again P into ER, because due to pre-stressing force the moment will be force into eccentricity. That one only we need to consider, that is P into E. The height of this triangle will be P into E. Now area of the triangle will be half into base into height, half into L by 2 into PE into x power 2 by 3 times the base of the triangle, 2 by 3 into L by 2. Now on simplification we get delta is equal to 1 by 12 PEL square by EI. It will be in upward direction and we need to take it as negative. It is about the second case. Now we shall go with the third case. Simply supported beam having parabolic cable profile which has eccentricity E at the midspan and zero at the support, that is concentric at the support. So this is the cable profile. It is a parabolic cable profile having eccentricity E at the midspan and concentric at the support. Now using the load balancing concept, we can write the bending moment diagram as a parabolic variation. The height will be same, that is P into E. Due to pre-stressing force now we are calculating, hence the height remains the same. This is P into E. Again applying the Mohr's theorem, delta is equal to A into x bar divided by EI, which is equal to area of this part, that is shaded region, 2 by 3 into base into height, 2 by 3, base is L by 2 and height is PE, into x bar. X bar means distance between this point to the support, that is x bar is equal to 5 by 8 times base. 5 by 8 times base is L by 2, 5 by 8 into L by 2, whole divided by EI. On simplification we get delta is equal to 5 by 48 PEL square by EI. It will be in the upward direction, hence we need to take it as negative. That is about the third case. Now fourth case, simply supported beam having parabolic cable having maximum eccentricity E1 at the midspan and minimum eccentricity E2 at the supports below the centroidal axis or towards the soffit of the beam. Say this line, what it is written in the black pen, it indicates the centroidal axis of the concrete. This cable profile indicates the centroidal axis of the cable. Now at the midspan the eccentricity is E1 and at the support the eccentricity is E2, that is below the centroidal axis. That is very important. On that condition only, if the cable lies below the centroidal axis, then the resultant bending diagrams will be negative. Both will be negative in this case. Say first we shall consider, due to pre-stressing force and eccentricity at midspan, there will be the parabolic variation P into, now the net deflection, sorry, the net sag of the cable, that is P into E1 minus E2, P into E1 minus E2, that will be the height of this bending moment diagram. In addition, there will be the another bending moment diagram which is having the intensity of P into E2. P into E2. Both diagrams will be negative, that is delta is equal to A into X bar divided by EI. Now we shall consider one after the other. First we shall consider this parabolic variation. Now area 2 by 3 times base into height, 2 by 3 into base, base is L by 2, height, height is P into E1 minus E2, into X bar from here to the support, 5 by 8 times L by 2, plus, now we shall consider the rectangular portion. The area will be P into E2 into L by 2, into X bar means L by 2 into 1 by 2, that will be L by 4, whole divided by EI. I have done the simplification here. On simplifying, we get this formula. Delta is equal to P L square divided by 48 EI into E2 plus 5 E1. The net deflection will be in the upward direction, since it is a pre-stressing force causing the deflection. Hence, we need to take it as negative. Next case. Compared with the previous case, here the cable profile at the support is above the centroidal axis of the concrete by an amount of eccentricity E2. Now the change is, it will be the same, the resultant bending moment in the parabolic variation will be same with the negative sign. Since at the support the parabolic cable is above the centroidal axis of the concrete, we need to take it as positive. In comparison with the previous case, the only change is positive sign here. Positive sign here. Now, delta is equal to, using Moore's theorem, Ax bar divided by Ei. If we are concentrating with the first bending moment diagram, we need to use the negative sign here. Since if we are using the second bending moment diagram, we need to use the positive sign here. Now by using the formula, area will be 2 by 3 times base into height into 5 by 8 L by 2, this is A into X bar of the parabolic region, plus P into E2 into L by 2, this is the area of the second bending moment diagram, into L by 2, so into L by 4, this is the x2 distance in this case. Now on simplification, we get this formula. I have done each and every step here. On simplification, we get P L square by 48 EI into E2 minus 5 E1. It will also be in that upward direction. Also we need to treat it as negative. Next, sixth one, it is also similar one. In case of parabolic, it is linearly bent here. The concept remains same. Since at the support and at the midspan, the cables are below the centroidal axis of the concrete, hence the resultant bending moment diagrams will be negative. Both are negative here. Say this is the first bending moment diagram. Height of this is P into E1 minus E2. Second one, constant eccentricity P into E2. Again, by using Moore's theorem, we can derive this formula. That is, delta is equal to P L square by 24 EI into E2 plus 2 E1. This type of derivation may be asked in the exams. It is very important. For 4 to 6 marks, these derivation may be asked. And the last one, simply supported beam having linearly bent cable having eccentricity E1 below the neutral axis at midspan and eccentricity E2 at the support above the centroidal axis. Say this is the resultant diagram here. Now since it is above the centroidal axis or neutral axis at the support, we have to take the second figure as positive. For first one, we have to use negative sign. For second one, we have to take the positive sign. On simplification, we are going to get this formula. That is, P L square by 24 EI into E2 minus 2 E1. This is the effect of different cable profiles on the deflection of the PSC beams. Suppose if any other type of cable profile is given other than this, then again we need to write down the resultant bending moment diagrams. Then by applying the Mohr's theorem only, we can calculate the resultant deflection. That is about the concept here. Now we shall go with the same concept. The same derivations are can be observed here. Here directly they have written here. In the previous case, I have explained everything. Next type of deflection, it is about the long-term deflection. Short-term deflection, it includes only due to dead load, live load, and pre-stressing force. Long-term deflection indicates, it indicates due to shrinkage, creep of the concrete. Deflection of the PSC member may vary due to time-dependent losses such as creep and shrinkage. Deflection produced due to live load, dead load, and pre-stress, including all time-dependent losses, are known as long-term losses. Due to time-dependent loss, there will be a decrease in pre-stress and corresponding decrease in deflection. Say, in order to calculate the long-term deflection, we need to use this formula. That is, delta is equal to delta due to dead load plus delta due to live load plus delta P. Delta P means deflection due to pre-stress into this effective ratio, loss ratio, P effective by PI. And this entire term should be multiplied with 1 plus phi, where this phi is the creep coefficient. Phi is the creep coefficient. Delta L means deflection due to dead load. Delta D means deflection due to dead load. Delta L means deflection due to live load. Delta P means deflection due to pre-stress and eccentricity. P effective means effective pre-stressing force. PI, initial pre-stressing force. Phi, creep coefficient. This ratio we can call it as loss ratio, that is neta. Neta is equal to, that is loss ratio is equal to P effective by PI. There is a caudal limitation for the deflection of the PSC beam, that is final downward deflection should not be greater than span by 250. The span should be substituted in millimeters. And also final upward deflection should not be greater than span by 300. These are the caudal limits for the deflection of PSC beams. This is about the theory part. In the next video, we shall solve the problems.